Hi, everybody. Dr. Bill Crawford here, psychologist, speaker, author of 7 books, host of 2 PBS specials. I'm here today in beautiful Whistler, British Columbia, doing another one of my leadership retreats for TEC Canada. And I thought I'd take this opportunity to shoot a short video, give you my thoughts on a subject that's come up a lot during my seminars lately. It's the concept of selflessness. Often I'll ask the seminar participants, hey, what are the qualities and characteristics you want to bring to life? And they say things like confident and happy and kind and compassionate and all those wonderful things. Every once in a while, someone will say selfless. And I really wonder about that because as the quote you may see in the quote that I'm sending out to those 5,000 folks on my quote list today says, you know, I really wonder if there is such a thing as a selfless act, and should there be? I don't think you have to be selfless in order to avoid being selfish. See, I think when people are saying selfless, what they really mean is I don't want to be selfish. I don't want to just always think about me. I want to think about others. But the idea that somehow getting something out of that, that we get some reward, or the person who is giving gets some of the reward as well, it's good for the self, it's good for the soul. I don't think that's incongruent with the concept of giving to others. Matter of fact, I think it supports it. I know for myself, one of the reasons I do what I do is to receive that wonderful adoration and appreciation from my audiences and from those that I do counseling with. I don't do it for the money. Now, the money kind of helps. It kind of allows me to do it. But I don't do it for the money. I do it for the experience I get from helping people. So it's that giving and receiving. I'm thinking that we can get into this in a way where we actually bring this to life. I was actually watching 60 Minutes not too long ago and saw this wonderful program on something called the Tanzanian Children's Fund. They did this wonderful piece on people who have created a village in Tanzania for 90 plus kids. Started out with 4, went to 9, now it's 90 plus kids. They give them a home, they give them a place to be. It's not just an orphanage. Matter of fact, it's not an orphanage at all. It's a home. They teach them, they have school, they have health care, not only for them, but for the entire community. It enriches the entire community. So these kids get something, obviously, from having a place to be. They would be orphans otherwise. The people who are running it talk about how much they get from the kids. I got something out of supporting that. Hey, if you want to get something out of supporting that too, I'd encourage you to Google it, the Tanzanian Children's Fund, or just go to their website and donate. It was a wonderful experience. And that's the beauty of doing something in a way that actually you get something out of it as well. It's not a selfless act. This is a giving, a receiving. It's a way of being that enriches the giver and the receiver. So as I encourage you to think about the qualities and characteristics you want to bring to life, I encourage you to really question the concept of selflessness. Is it really about having less self in the situation or more in the way that you get something out of the experience? If you want me to come and talk to your organization about any of this, because all of this comes from that upper 80% of the brain. Selfish comes from the lower 20% of the brain. Doing for others and getting something out of it comes from the upper 80% of the brain. This is what I do. All you got to do is go to my website, BillCrawfordPhD.com, hit the contact button, let me know what you're interested in, and I'd love to talk with you about that. In the meantime, here's to you bringing more clarity, confidence, creativity to everything you do, doing for others and letting it be meaningful for yourself as well. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.